Phil Leggett is a household name in cycling, otherwise also known as the voice of the sport around the world. The Cape Town Cycle Tour is an event he has a rich history with. He joined a few on a fun ride in Cape Town ahead of the race.
I first came here in 1989. It was then called the Argus Cycle Tour, and it had an entry of 12,500 people. And since then, of course, we've seen it grow and grow and grow. It's now the Cycle Tour. I won't say it's the calm before the storm, because this wind is raging today and it's pretty hard. But on Sunday, I think the wind's going to be a big problem. I just hope it goes off without a hitch this time around.
Leggett has been witness to many races over his years as a broadcaster, and feels the Cape Town Cycle Tour is a special one that keeps him coming back.
My big race every year is the Tour de France, and I've covered that now for 46 years. I mean, it's quite ridiculous, isn't it? But this isn't a multi-day race. This is a one-off race. But it is a race, and that's the big difference to all the other one-day rides around the world that aren't professional races, of course. Everybody gets a time, whether you want it or not. Others come here, they don't even look at their time. All they want to do is have a lovely ride on closed roads around the Cape. But it is a race, and for the professionals up front, of course, very much a race, because there's big prize money to win as well.
Leggett praises South Africa's Nicholas Dlamini, albeit without being able to say his surname.
You've got the newcomers coming through now, like Nicholas Dlamini. I can never say his name properly, but he's a good guy. He is in the World Tour team Dimension Data. He's only 23, and he's come the hard way to be a pro bike rider. And now he's become a real star in Cape Town, but he's also a name around the world now. Two more years, he'll be riding the Tour de France, and it all started right here.
The women's race will, for the second year, have its own start point.
It was always a problem with this event. Where do you start the women and not have the men interfere? Because the groups start every 3, 4, 5 minutes apart. The women were catching the slower men. The faster men behind were catching the women. They were merging. Then the women were being paced by the men. The women were complaining, it's not fair. Now we're starting along the road, 40 kilometres further down the road, and they'll start 15 minutes ahead.
Cyclists can expect windy conditions along the peninsula, which should make the race tricky, but not cancel it. Justin Ford, Cape Town.